Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be watching Loki episode 5, which is called Journey into Mystery.
Hell yes. I'm assuming that's a reference to the comic run Journey into Mystery, which I believe was where 90% of the characters in this series were introduced. So it's a nice little touch to the fans there.
Well, it's going
to
be a lot. Obviously the post-credit scene, not the end of the episode, but the post-credit scene showed Loki, surprise, surprise, not being dead, but waking up in like a different kind of dimension or world where he met 4 other Lokis.
Three, as we initially assumed.
Yeah, we were too sort of starstruck by all of them to notice little alligator Loki, who's arguably the coolest one.
Yeah, so. Best name I saw for him was Florida Loki. He is 100% canon now, Florida Loki.
Which could be Floki if you shortened it.
Ooh. Yeah. So we have Floki, Blokey.
Yeah, Floki, Blokey.
Cloaky for King Loki.
Yeah.
Or Kid Loki.
Loki. Anyway, big city. But yeah, there is sort of King Loki or Old Man Loki. There is Kid Loki, Gator Loki, and so honourable, boastful Loki with his little makeshift hammer. And so, yeah, so A Journey into Mystery is probably going to be revolving around that quite a lot.
Yeah, I guess it's going to be backstories for all the various Loki.
You don't watch the trailers, but I did actually watch the trailer last week because I was hyped after this episode. So from the trailer, kind of know not that much. I've forgotten most of it, but I think we see Mobius in a scene that we haven't seen him in before. So I think that means he's alive.
Yeah, after we saw Loki wake up, it was kind of a giveaway. Yeah. We have to assume that Mobius has been sent to a similar place where he's meeting.
But I'm just glad that we see him again. So
is he Starsky or Hutch? I can't remember.
I don't know.
A bunch of other Owen Wilsons.
Yeah, which would be hilarious. So, I wonder if he's ended up on the same world. Because obviously the other stuff that's on the world that Loki's on is stuff like, you know, the battered tower from, like, the Avengers movie and stuff is in the background. So, when you see shot, you can see some of the stuff from, like, I think from New York.
Some kind of giant cosmic
stuff.
Dumping ground.
Yeah, basically. But for, like... Loki's and Loki related things.
I wonder if that's like the place, because obviously, you know, energy can't be created or destroyed. I'm wondering if when they break things down with the grenades, if that's all being sent to this big like dumping dimension, and it's going to be all the variants that they've melted have all gone there.
Yeah, I don't know if it's one whole like generic dumping ground or if it's a Loki specific dumping ground, which I'm inclined to think, from what we've seen so far, it's that. But we've also got, obviously, we had Sylvie. She was asking Ravonna Renslayer that she wanted to know everything. So we're going to find out what happens with them. Basically, last episode was fucking awesome.
So good.
And left lots and lots of questions that we're really excited to get into this episode and find out lots and lots of answers, hopefully. Mm.
Yeah, although doubtfully. Well, it's the penultimate episode, so it's probably going to answer one or two questions and then pose like
bring up a load
more.
Yeah. Do you have anything else that you want to add before we jump in?
Nope.
Okay. So, guys, if you like our reactions, please remember to like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell so you're notified of any future uploads as soon as we upload them. The link to our Twitter is down below in the description. We also upload regular polls over there as well. And apart from that, do you want to get into it?
Yeah, let's do this thing.
I really love the aesthetics of the TVA.
Like in the little kind of, is it an hourglass, is it an Ouroboros? It's a bow tie. Bow ties are cool.
This is getting me really hyped for this episode. I love this show! Yeah, this is the weird planet of, like, dumping ground buildings and stuff. I think maybe it's stuff that they erase from other timelines, they just put here.
Yeah, they dumped all their Loki variant nonsense in one big place.
Yeah. This is not time for your silly quips. Come on!
That's not great.
Oh, hello.
Oh, that's cool.
What is that? A dragon?
Badass, whatever it is.
So they dump you on a planet that has some giant dragon thing, so that it'll hopefully
eat you. It's a chronophage.
Who's really behind the TVA?
I'm as in the dark as you are.
Bullshit.
Judge Renslayer. This is it, isn't it? This is where you dragged me after you stole my life. A fitting place, then, to take yours.
And what if I said Loki wasn't dead?
Not yet, anyway.
I'd say you were lying.
Maybe. I'm telling you this willingly.
Why?
Because I want to know who's at the top of this. I want to know who lied to me.
She doesn't know. Is she lying?
Yeah.
When we prune a branched reality, it's impossible to destroy all that's matter.
So we move it to a place on the timeline where it won't continue growing. A void at the end of time.
I don't believe anything she says now.
Yeah.
Nothing ever comes back from there. Can help you if you trust me.
You've not been very trustworthy up until now, girl.
You know how to earn her trust, but you just don't want to do it.
I don't know. I mean, it's...
Is that?
She has been a questionable character. As we said, she might have just been...
Is that a head
Look at him! Like a little gator, Loki.
Will someone please explain to me what the hell is going on?
It's been a very, very, very trying past few days. And now I'm surrounded by variants of myself, plus an alligator, which I'm heartbroken to report I didn't even find. Well, that's strange. Now I'm running to God knows what, trying to get to God knows where. So the thing I need to be doing is trying to find...
This is the place where the TVA dumps its rubbish. Alliance, he ensures none of it ever returns.
We're in a shark tank. Lilith is the shark. There's no such thing as an alligator tank. He's only sensitive like the rest of us.
You're telling me that thing's a Loki too?
Oh, yes.
Look at its little helmet. Yeah.
Okay. I'm willing to accept that.
I love alligator Loki.
Why do you wear the horns? Let the child command you.
You do well to respect the boy.
Right. What was your Nexus event, Your Majesty?
I killed Thor.
Ooh. How's that going to make him feel?
That's definitely Yellow Jacket's helmet there from Ant-Man. But massive, because Yellow Jacket.
Ant-Man, yeah.
Yeah. Hey, the Thanos Copter! Best vehicle in all of Marvel. Also the shittest, because that's just how Marvel works.
Are you excited about Loki?
Hey! Yeah. There's his Thor's Mjolnir.
So, why did you want to return to the TVA so badly anyway?
You leave your glorious purpose there.
I love how they always loop the other... Like episode that. Titles into here somehow. Nexus event, glorious purpose.
Miss Minutes, I need you to remote access a series of restrictions.
I think Miss Minutes is the baddie.
I was just about to say the exact same thing.
What about the end of time? It's just a void. What if there's something beyond it?
She's suspicious. Suspicious little clock lady.
What about the void spacecraft?
Yes, the prototype.
Is she helping? She looks suspicious.
Yeah, I just don't trust anyone in the show anymore.
It's hard to trust a hologram.
Unless he's called Rimmer.
Together. It's highly restricted. I might not even have clearance.
Oh no, I think you would. If it's real.
Yeah.
Any second now.
Yeah. Knew not to trust her. Yeah, she did.
Help me? It must be so exhausting.
You're exhausting.
Help me. Let me fall there for a minute. Or did you get a little real? Why don't you come back out and we can talk about it?
Sure. Just tell everyone else to piss off and we can settle this between us.
Tell you what, you come out with your hands up and I'll put you in a time loop.
That's not necessary.
Something not so bad. You can live out your days in a good memory. Do you have any good memories?
Just one, really.
Is that when she was a kid or when she was with Loki?
Oh. That's a great question.
Smart! But is she going to go to the same place?
Yeah.
And she's got her temp pad.
She does!
Now you said a lion is what keeps us here. You said it's a shark. Well, if it lives, it dies. So I'm going to kill the shark. I'm going to kill a lion. And I could use all the help I can get.
I'm pretty sure if an alligator could laugh, they'd be laughing at you right now. Oh shit!
Hello.
It's President Loki.
But there was exactly him that, like, the one that looked like him.
The one that spoke was President Loki.
Okay. Forgive me if I can't keep track.
Yeah, it's quite a few. We need to... Well, this doesn't look good.
Is she on the right planet? I think so.
It looks shit enough, but... It's got the same terrifying music.
Oh, that's close.
Getting serious Lost flashbacks. Oh. The hell was
what
that?
Does she do?
I don't know.
Is that going to be Loki? Or is it Mobius?
Oh, please be Mobius. Although he's not on a jet ski, so it probably isn't him.
It's Mobius, I think it's Mobius.
Yeah.
Yeah! It's got pizza on it. Of course you'd jump in.
I totally would too.
Nothing can change until the TVA is stopped.
And you trust her.
She's the only one I do trust. And right now, I believe she's our only chance of stopping the TVA.
And I love her.
The only thing that matters now is getting out of here and finding out who's behind all of this.
Don't leave him there.
How do we do that?
With this.
And turn around.
Turn around?
Back to the angry cloud.
Yes. I think it might be the answer. We're going back to it.
Believe in the power of Pizza Car.
Oh, hello. That's the USS Eldridge. Why does that ring a bell?
Yeah. Goliath is like any animal. He'll go after the big bugging me.
While he's busy with that, we can sneak around the back and...
It's like, do you realise how big it is? Oh! Yeah, doesn't look that killable.
It's just bundle of living
fog.
Smoke.
Yeah.
There's no heart or brain, there's just anger and lightning. Must be a Thor variant.
Maybe we think a bit.
Don't
more
do this.
Come.
Yeah.
Sophie.
I don't understand. Is he a coward or was he being brave?
He's being love struck. Which is somewhere between the two. And the question is, will it be more happy to see Sylvie or Mobius?
You're alive.
What happened? You okay? Mobius, how did you?
We thought you could do with some backup.
I like that she fed his ego a bit there. That's nice of her.
So you're all after the giant cloud monster too, then?
We haven't decided how we're going to kill it.
Sorry, come again. Kill it?
Yes, we're going to kill Goliath.
Oh my god, that was your plan. And you all went along with it.
I was having my doubts.
Alright. What's your plan then?
I think the person we're after is beyond the void at the end of time. That thing is just their guard dog.
So, how do we get past the guard dog?
I'm going to enchant it.
That's big.
She's pretty confident.
I love how much this show makes me laugh.
It's got a very distinctly British sense of humour. And I'm very, very into that, for obvious reasons.
This one does not make me laugh.
No.
Makes me scowl.
Oh?
Oh, you leave her alone.
Why am I locked in here? You freed the Varian. You were disloyal to the TVA.
Disloyal to who? You were in the Timekeeper's chambers. They weren't real.
And why do you think that changes anything?
That changes everything. The TVA needs stability.
For what?
And until we can figure
she
out
knows.
What's going on, that is what it will get.
She definitely knows.
So you need to tell me everything. You had a link with the Varian. I want you to tell me what drives her.
Killing the Timekeepers. But they turned out to be fake in case you forgot. So she'll be searching for whomever created them.
She knows. She must know.
This isn't about protecting the TVA at all, is it?
Did she create them?
Find whoever's behind all of this too.
Oh. because she doesn't know.
I need all the files on the family of the TVA.
Well, that's a mighty tall order.
Whoever created this place is in danger. I need to find them.
Okay.
Right away, Minutes. It's really annoying. I love Miss Minutes, but I feel like she's evil.
She is, yeah.
She's quite expressionate for a hologram, and her eyes are all like, yeah, I'll go sort that out now.
Yeah.
TVA arrest a lot of Lokis, but no. I mean, who's to say he's even a Loki variant?
He's green, isn't he?
He could be lying. A long con. Of course, that just makes him more likely to be a Loki.
I wonder if Florida Loki's from the same universe as Throg.
Assuming...
I'm just letting them two do it together.
So bad.
What's so good? I think that's why they get along.
He cares about you.
Look at him. Oh, the field.
Oh. Yeah, so awkward.
It's gone. Do you want my jacket? Shuffle up a little.
Conjure one for you if you like.
That's the closest is to...
Tell you what, you could conjure me a new outfit. You have no idea how uncomfortable something like this is.
I can imagine what the outfit he'd pick. Make her a little bit colder, I think.
Theory.
Event.
Total rubbish, right?
Absolutely.
I don't mean that it wasn't, you know, a nice moment.
No, it was great.
It just sounds like another TVA lie.
100%.
That them two together is enough to cause...
Yeah.
Well, because they're not supposed to like each other as themselves.
Technically, this is just about Loki actually loving Loki. It doesn't matter which Loki it is. It's all...
I don't even know what we're doing. Anyone.
There are more important things.
Yeah, like bringing down the TVA.
Saving the universe, when you think about it.
Well, there's no need to be dramatic, but yeah.
You're a Loki, there needs to be dramatic.
Aww. That's what he wanted to do the whole time. It's so weird that they're the same person, but I love them. Should be making her as comfortable as possible, considering she's about to enchant a giant angry cloud.
You won't betray me.
Listen, Sylvie, I betrayed everyone who ever loved me. I know what I did, and I know why I did it. And that's not who I am anymore. I won't let you down.
You sure?
Oh.
I really hope he doesn't.
He might let her down, but I don't think he'll betray her.
Yeah.
What about you? What will you do when this is all over?
You.
It'd be great if we find out she's not a Loki and makes it a bit less weird, but why do I feel like one of them's going to die?
Maybe. Yep.
Maybe we can figure it out.
Together?
Don't say it.
Together?
Yeah. One of them's definitely going to die.
Yep. It's probably going to be her, considering she's...
What are these little things?
They're so cool.
They don't have heads. They're just like bouncing a little ball on the top of their neck. And yet they're still adorable. Hmm. Can she not channel all the Loki's power or something?
This might be what happens.
I don't know if that's possible.
That's fucking teamwork.
Because she's the only one that can enchant, isn't she?
Which is why I think she's not actually a Loki.
Yeah.
What's the next move? The TVA needs to be brought down. You don't know who created it or where they are, but that thing out there does. When it hit me...
How do you know that? Okay, that's what she did.
That's...
And it's
going to
take me to whoever's behind all of this.
Which will be another Loki.
Is she going to give the temp pad to someone? Yeah. Although he broke the last one, so maybe he's not.
Yeah.
Probably give it to Mobius. I feel like he knows how to use it a lot better. Mobius.
Your other boyfriend.
Yeah. He's much better with him.
Please do. What? No. We're staying here.
This is our home.
What?
You sure?
He's mad. Hey.
So,
well, if they can kill Eliath, they can live there happily.
It's kind of like the sword he had in Agent of Asgard.
So is he going back to the TVA?
I think so, yeah.
Why?
To fuck some shit up.
Wouldn't he wait to see if they're okay?
Burn it to the ground.
Yeah. That's my boy Mobius.
Oh, they better see each other again.
Yeah.
Give him a hug. Oh, I'm gonna cry. Why am I getting emotional over this?
You're my favourite.
He whispers that he thinks he means him.
No, I'm pretty sure they both know who he was talking to.
But he looks at Sylvie like...
Yeah.
I'd want everyone to just be okay and stay friends. I want one of these weird birds. They should stick around and help. I feel like they could help.
Maybe it'll be looking a bit down and then they'll charge in and be like, Loki power!
All of them, yeah. Seems like a waste to have them all there and not help. Is that the Avengers ship?
Yeah, the helicarrier.
Yeah.
I thought I saw it earlier, but I think I was wrong in that step. Oh, right. He's setting up for something.
He's gonna do it.
He's gonna cause a distraction.
Oh, I'm so tense. It's actually unreal how much I love this fucking show.
Okay, that's definitely Graham.
Flame dagger. Or just like one you can kind of enchant.
Yeah, he can give a different elemental enchantment. Pretty cool sword.
This all looks so cool.
Oh crap. Much like everyone else, Elias is more interested in Sylvie.
No. No, it worked. Did it work?
I don't know.
No, she's there still, I think.
Yeah.
Oh! Hey!
I told you, it was all going to look grim. And then my boy was going to show up and save the day because Loki power.
What is he doing? Making Asgard?
Yeah.
Fuck, he's strong. Well, maybe Loki can probably do that, but...
He'd need to practice a bit.
Fuck yeah.
That's why he's the king.
Oh, I've got chills. This feels like a finale as well.
Yeah, which makes me worry about how hype the next one's going to be.
I don't want to cry. Together! But when are you?
At this point, the evidence all does kind of point that way.
What, that they are the same?
Yeah.
Or they're going to find out they're not. Oh no. Hey!
I have the power! No, classic Loki, no. You can do it. An alligator Loki comes in and just eats it.
Yeah. Oh, go on, Richard. Oh. Oh. Oh.
Wow.
Green dragon.
Everything is green in the end.
Open your eyes.
Is this the void?
I think that's what's beyond the void.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Are they going through it?
Looks suspiciously like Doomstat, which would make me lose my shit. Would explain the green too. Don't you fucking dare.
Is it time? Oh! That did not feel like...
40 minutes.
50 minutes.
That was like 20 minutes tops.
Fuck.
God damn it.
Just to let you know, guys, the reason this episode is out so late is because we're watching... The Hound was busy, and then... We're watching England in the Euros final tonight, which I imagine is going to be very tense. And I feel like I've just experienced half of that in this episode.
Yep. That was... Whew. Oh, that was something. God. So good.
That episode was amazing. It felt like 10 minutes. And yeah, I don't know if I'm just riding the hype wave of this right now, but like, that just right now, that feels like one of the best episodes I've seen of anything.
For sure. Yeah, that was just phenomenal. It had like it was quite a strong self-contained story. Like, it was just, you know, Loki being Loki for 40 minutes. But there were so many cool little, like, Easter eggs and little nods to the other films. Like, there really was something in there for everything. And it was just, I loved every second of that episode.
I was not expecting to be so, like, emotional. Like, when they're all saying bye, just the sweetness. Because it's not something you see from Loki. You get glimpses of it throughout, obviously, the films. And, you know, when he starts to soften and he helps out Thor and stuff. And that's kind of the Loki you always want to kind of hope for.
Yeah.
And because he's always a character, I feel that you always feel a little bit sorry for. Yeah, I personally do. Yeah. Because, you know, he didn't get the love of his... He was kind of taken from his original parents, and then his real parents didn't really like love and see the stuff in him that he wanted, because he obviously was in the shadow of Thor all the time. And he's just a kind of misunderstood kid, really, you know, who, and so you always kind of feel a bit bad for him. So actually seeing him make these like really strong personal connections with people who like care about him back, and he has his own world. I really loved the line that she said to him, when it's like, she's clearly got more of a plan and is more badass than he is, but she came along and was like, we figured you needed some backup. And it was like, that's just a really nice, like, little ego boost for him, because that's how he likes to portray himself. But secretly, I think he knows, you know, he knows his downfalls and stuff like that. And so it was nice for her to sort of be like, yeah, we're here to help you, you know,
pump up a little
not
bit,
the
yeah.
other way around. Yeah,
I'm not here to rescue you, we're here to help you, yeah. assist,
yeah,
play wingman.
Oh, and then all the old Loki, like,
what a boss.
Yeah, I kind of knew he was going to come in. I thought the others were going to help out as well, but like,
yeah, not really sure what he could have done at that point.
No, but he sacrificed himself, and it was really sad. And then so I think we know that Sylvie is a Loki, if
yeah.
she was able to, also, if he was also able to enchant, it means they would have the same set of powers, unless she just channels it like through him. Oh, and Mobius, I hope so we see more of him. I hope he is going to go and just fuck up all of the TVA, starting with fucking Renslayer. I hate that bitch.
She's just annoying. It kind of feels like they're setting her up to pull some last minute cool shit. Like,
I thought that in the last episode. So at the beginning I was like, no, she's lying. And then I was like, actually, maybe she's not lying.
Like, she clearly wants to find out who's in charge. But why, and what is she going to do with that information? And
well, maybe she just wants to know why she's been lied to all this time. But
fair enough.
Stop acting like a bitch then. Just when she's speaking to B17,
I think.
59, 52, B-52s, the B lady. When she's speaking to her, you know, don't be a dick about it. Just ask if you for the help, if you want to know. Don't have to go around threatening everyone and being an asshole about it. But yeah, I said it last episode, and I feel like we may vary on this, but definitely the best show from the Marvel Universe so far, but 100%. For me, one of the best things I think I've ever seen in the Marvel Universe. I would say nothing else has made me have the sort of feels and excitement and, like, I mean, you know, and normally we see these things on cinema screens, and we're just watching it at home. This whole episode, I was just like, wow, like, that this looks so cool.
That would have looked so good on a cinema. Yeah. When they were fighting Iloth, and it was just like this Goliath.
Yeah.
Just this massive smoke, which would have looked so
good. Which is obviously like Goliath, but it's an A, which makes me think it might be a big alligator, but an alligator Goliath thing.
There were distinctly alligatory.
Yeah, he did look a bit more like that than a features. Dragon. So maybe little alligator Loki knows more than it's letting on.
Maybe he's a Goliath variant and not a Loki variant. Just stole someone's hat after eating them.
But apart from, I think Infinity War is probably the only thing that's ever really given me the kind of
that final sequence, the dusting sequence in Infinity War.
Well, that whole fight,
a lot of feels.
Like that fight. I mean, yes, a lot. I know there's a lot of cheers and people loved the stuff in Endgame and stuff like that. And I really do enjoy the sort of end half of Endgame, but I personally preferred Infinity War as a film a lot better than Endgame. I thought it was full of a lot more kind of feeling and unexpected stuff. But the fight when they're all in Wakanda and they're all marching together, there's something just about that that just like makes me like, oh, there we go. you know, Wakanda forever. And I think that this show is probably the thing that's gotten me the most excited and on the edge of my seat and up in my feels, and I just love it. I love all the content as well. It's all so cool. I've always liked the kind of spacey Viking stuff more, but you know, the fact that we are in space,
Thor is
the
time travel back into Marvel,
with the weird giant dragon thing or whatever, and then you've got, you know, it's cool.
Yeah. But I saw online someone describing Loki as the best season of Doctor Who we've had in years, which is just a perfect description. It's got that whole kind of, you know, madman trying to save the world with time travel and dimension hopping. It's right there. Dan Renkley really wants Tom Hiddleston as the Doctor, or Sophie DeMartino. She would be quite good too. Although we were a bit worried. It seemed like someone was going to die.
Yeah, I think it still might.
I have a suspicion if they do, it will be Sylvie, just because there's been a lot of sort of talk with a lot of praise for the costume department in this series. Because they've hidden the fact that Sophie was 6 months pregnant for the majority of the filming.
Wow.
Yeah.
Did she do a lot of her own stunts? Because she's been very active.
She did not. I think she did. But yeah, so it's entirely possible that she would be on sort of maternity leave while they would be filming season two. So either they'll kill her off.
Season two, that's so exciting.
Or possibly they'll just...
Well, I mean, the reason I say one or the other, because you think it would be obvious that it wouldn't be Loki that dies.
They're all Loki,
Yeah, but that's the thing. And somebody made a good point on another channel. It's like, if we're having female Thor and we're carrying these things on and passing a torch over, like, who's to say that the person that carries it on isn't female Loki? I don't think so, but, you know. They can't, if they make her die, it's just going to crush Loki. Him. Yeah. And I don't want to see that happen to him, because I feel like he's finally got some, like, happiness and glorious purpose in his life.
Well, I would, something, there was that very kind of romantic scene with the blanket, and then I don't know why, I make lots of jokes about them hooking up, because it's really, really funny, and they keep coming to me, but I don't really see anything romantic between the two of them. I don't think it's about Loki falling in love and banging one of his variants.
No,
I think it's very much the whole point of this show, and introducing all the different Lokis and like having them all kind of get together and do things, which is also what I think the final villain will be, another Loki, because that's just a new thing. It's, this whole show is about Loki accepting himself for who he is, and there's no better way to do that to show how close he's become with one. Like, the closeness between him and Sylvie is just him learning to accept and love himself for who he is.
Yeah, but
which has been this recurring thing.
It could just be friends. Like, she's like, I don't know how to do this, and you know. And I think there might be a bit, I don't know, they just feel very closely bonded and together when both of them maybe haven't felt that before. Even when Loki obviously loved his brother and his mum, he never felt like accepted and stuff by anybody really. And whereas obviously they're going to feel that from each other, because they're the same person. They understand each other on a sort of deeper level. So
he's learning to accept himself, which is the most important thing to do.
Accept yourself. Anyway. I don't know who I'd be more upset if they died, if it was Sylvie or Mobius. I feel like I just want Mobius. I'd be all right if, like, I want to see Mobius in it, but I'd be all right if he just gets put somewhere where he can be happy and have a jet ski.
Yeah, I think the best part, like, if in season two, I would be happy if there was no Mobius, as long as, like, either the post credit for the finale or in the kind of denouement at the end of the season where they're wrapping up all the various plot points, we see him jet skiing off into the sunset. I would be very happy if that was the last, that was the end of his story. It's like, either they put him in charge of the TVA and he becomes the new timekeeper, or he gets to relax as a professional jet skier. I think that would be the best scenario for him. Yeah. I don't think we really need to keep him around, unless season two is Loki running the TVA, which would be hilarious, to be fair. I would watch that.
I just, I don't know how it's going to go with that. I'm so happy there's season two. Mm. I love this show. I'm gutted that there's one more episode, but I feel like it's built up really well. So I'd be annoyed if the next episode is a disappointment, because the last two episodes have been absolute fire. Have been so, so good. Oh, it's I'm sure risky. I had more stuff to say.
Yes. They broke through, they defeated alligator, ghost alligator, space monster, and there was a castle there. I don't know what that castle is, but literally the first thing I saw when I saw that was that is Doomstadt, castle of Dr. Victor Von Doom. The perennial enemy of literally everyone in the Marvel Universe, because he has better tech than Iron Man and better magic than Stephen Strange.
Which would make sense. Don't at me,
you know it's true. Introducing him now, it would be a bit odd, but would also be fucking cool as hell, because I love Dr. Doom. He's a boss.
And
he's green.
Miss Minutes, who goes very well with Dr. Doom. Miss Minutes, Dr. Doom. But she, yeah, I want to know. I want to know you can't read her because she's not real.
Nah.
But is she real? I don't know.
What would be really cool is if they were like, it's Miss Minutes, she's Tara Strong, little and adorable. And then they got to the big end and she was just like, brah, and just transformed into like a big, giant, evil red clock with claws.
Monster Minutes.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Miss Monster.
I'm fine with either of those.
Man, I'm probably going to have to watch that episode again because I felt like it just flew by and it was great. So I can't wait to actually just watch that again. Mm. Or you get to edit, which is going to be really hard, but you get to at least watch all that through again, which is going to be pretty cool.
This is going to suck.
And yeah, Easter egg galore. There were so many like bits and bobs from other like Marvel films and stuff thrown into that world, which was really, really cool. I wonder if the pizza cart's from anything. It'd be great if it was shawarma.
I don't know why. Now you mention it, I think...
And
someone like Hawkeye drove a pizza car for, or Deadpool drove
and the
a pizza
ship
car
as well, the USS something. That rings a bell too, so I have to look that up too. Anyway, just trickling on a little bit. So anything else you want to say before we wrap it up?
Good.
So amazing episode, guys. Sad that there's only one left of this awesome, awesome series, but if you like our reactions, please remember to like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell so you're notified of any future uploads as soon as we upload them. The link to our Twitter is down below in the description, and we hold regular polls over there as well, so be sure to check that out. And apart from that, see you next time, guys.
See you around.